It's March the 9th, 1945, and on the Pacific island of Tinian, more than 300 B-29 bombers are taking off and heading northwest.
B-29s. Their noses point towards Japan.
Just after midnight, they reach their target.
Bombs for Tokyo.
Thousands of feet below, 8-year-old Haruyo Nihei ran for her life as the firestorm spread.
Parents were running from the flames carrying babies on their backs, and other children running beside them. I saw the babies on their backs catching fire. The mothers were going insane. Soon, the parents and the other children were covered in flames too. Everyone was burning.
In this tiny private museum, one of the M69 bombs, incendiaries designed specifically to set Japan's wooden houses alight.
The city burned until 5 a.m. By then, everything had been consumed. I was dragged out. I looked down where I had been lying. At least 10 people had been lying on top of me. All of them were dead, charred and blackened. I was saved by the people who died.
At the back of this little-known shrine, hidden from public view, I am allowed in to see this, the urns of the dead. It is very strange to walk among the ashes of 105,000 people.
It was the single deadliest night of bombing in history. And yet most Japanese people these days don't even know that these urns are stored here. Around the world, the bombing has been all but forgotten. And even here in Japan, it is barely commemorated.
10-year-old Kisako Motoki was also running that night. At dawn, she arrived at this bridge.
When I got to this bridge, it was blocked by a huge pile of burned and blackened bodies. So many, I couldn't cross the bridge. I just stood there, frozen. I looked in the river. The water was covered with bodies, too.
The firestorm killed both her parents and her brother. Kisako is still angry.
Maybe our government doesn't want to upset the Americans. The bombing was indiscriminate. It killed over 100,000 people. But until now, no investigation has been done. This is a strange country.
U.S. Air Force General Curtis LeMay said if America had lost the war, he would have been tried as a war criminal for what he did to Tokyo. But today, just 70 years on, what happened here has been all but erased from history. Rupert Wingfield-Hayes, BBC News in Tokyo.